There were a lot of dynasties in China long ago. They were big and strong, and their land was a great wall. Most people looked at them with honor and with pride, but to the Mongols it was such a fertile land. They would preach Confucius like a preacher, full of opium and fire. But they also had a lot of features empires would desire. Shang Dynasty, first to have a rivalry, they all knew how to read and write. Zhou Dynasty had many philosophies. Shang were thrown out with the mandate. Xing Dynasty made a lot of currency. They also made the terracotta.
Zhou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Huan, Qing, Shou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Huan, Qing, Zhou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Huan, Qing. Zhou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song.
They ruled the Chinese land, and never mind the nobles, but the newfound dynasties would overtake the throne. In all affairs of China, they were the men to please, but they were real great when they had a lot of tea. For the peasants, they were a bunch of land stealers, though they heard the things they done. They believed they were benevolent leaders who would heal their country. Han Dynasty, golden age of the Chinese. They invented books and paper. Tang Dynasty, gunpowder was their weaponry. Made China the largest nation in the world. Qing Dynasty was a British colony. Fell due to their own country.
But when their drinking and lusting and their hunger for power became known to more and more people, that a man to do something about these outrages, they became louder and louder.
Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Huan, Qing, Shou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Huan, Huan, Qing, Zhou, Sui, Ming, Tang, Song, Shang, Qing, Han, Zhou, Sui, Ming, Tang.
This man just got to go. Declared his enemies, but the nobles begged, "Don't you try to do it, please." No doubt these emperors had lots of it in arms. Though they were some brutes, they just took a lot of farms. Then one night some men of higher standing set a trap they were not to blame. Come to visit us, they kept demanding, and he really came. Sun Yat-sen, lover of democracy, they put some communists into his land. Sun Yat-sen, China's greatest revolution machine, they fought them all and said, "I surrender." Mao Zedong, lover of communism, he didn't quit, he wanted reforms. Mao Zedong, China's greatest industrial machine, and so he revolutionized it till he was dead.
Oh, those Chinese.